welcome to Wisdom One-on-One. I want you to call someone, tell them Wisdom One-on-One is on. We are starting a new series today. I'm actually excited. I've never done this series before, so it's going to be a ride that we are going to go into revelation knowledge. Every series that I go into has got a deep connection to the heartbeat of God. I remember when God appeared to me first time, and the first time I heard the audible voice of God was concerning what we are going to deal with. Now, if it's your first time catching Wisdom One-on-One, I want you to get excited, because Wisdom One-on-One gives you a platform where you can have a one-on-one with wisdom. A lot of people would have loved to have a time to be with David. A lot of people would have loved to meet Solomon. A lot of people would have loved to spend time with Joseph. A lot of people would have loved to spend time with Apostle Paul. A lot of people would have loved to spend time with our Lord and King, our Lord Jesus Christ. But most people did not have that time. Our program that God has given us, which is Wisdom One-on-One, gives you an access to the wisdom of God. Meaning, it makes you connect to the Spirit of God when it comes to understanding, illumination, revelation, insight, depth of things that you can encounter. So every time you hear Wisdom One-on-One is on, or Wisdom One-on-One is coming on, I want you to get excited. I want you to create a debt, because this is literally a debt with destiny. I've been meeting people and they're telling me, sir, what you're teaching, it's working. And you see, what people do not understand is this. God told me, I think this was about 4 years ago, between 4 to 5 years ago, God told me, I am Wisdom One-on-One. And I was in a prayer session and I was dealing with the Bible school students. We're dealing with the mystery of death, understanding death. And how that we are the most potent, the most powerful when we are dead. So I was teaching that mystery on death. And as I was doing that, we went into prayers. As we went into prayers, deep in the prayers, God came and told me to say, I am Wisdom One-on-One. So why I'm bringing that in is this. You must understand that when I sit here and I begin to teach, God wants to reach people. God wants to heal people. God wants to deliver people. God wants to bring restoration. God wants to bring His will, His purpose. God wants to bring transformation. God wants to bring prosperity, success. God wants to bring promotion. And God wants people to live a fulfilled life. So every time you are watching Wisdom One-on-One, you are having a one-on-one with God. Literally, because I yield myself to God to hear at any particular time, what does God want to say? What does He want me to deal with? And when He drops something in my heart, I go that direction. And I'll go in a particular direction, do a series. After that series is done, again, I wait on Him to go in a particular direction. And it has been like that from the inception of Wisdom One-on-One. So today's series, we are starting Wisdom for Building a Kingdom Family. Now, families have been under attack. If you've seen, I think 2 years ago, I was very hurt when I heard the stats. The stats were saying that the church was now superseding and hitting more divorces than even the world. People were divorcing more in the church than even outside. That the church that was once held as a pillar, a model, a sign, was now being affected the same way the world was being affected. Now, if you're in the school of wisdom, you know that Solomon said there's nothing new under the sun. So I want us to now go into the Word of God to find out, has this issue of divorce, brokenness in marriages, brokenness in homes, this issue of children rebelling, children becoming rebellious, parents failing to raise children, this issue of people ending up in a place of divorce, pain, frustration, broken relationship, which leads to now a permanent brokenness in the people that are broken. Has this thing been there before? Now, like I have quoted Solomon, Solomon said there's nothing new under the sun. So I want us to go into the pages of scripture. Now, why this is major for me personally is this is what God told me when he appeared to me. So we are now going deep into the assignment that God gave me when we go into this series. And we are going to hit some things that God has revealed to me over the past 22 years. I believe this is going to be one of the most transforming series you've ever sat under. If you're a family man, if you want to get married, if you are married, if you want to enjoy your marriage, if you want to ever have any relationship that will work, relationship to get married, relationship with somebody who has employed you, relationship at any level, this is a series that I want you to follow. Because we are going to look at how do you build a family. It can be a business family. It can be the actual family, the home. It can be a family in the community. We are going to break down family and look at the different aspects of family that we are supposed to attend to, with the focus being the actual family, which is the husband, the wife, and the children, and the extended family. So I want you to open with me. I pray you have your Bible, because with this one, like anything that I teach, we need to open the scriptures. Now, listen to the theme or the title of what we're dealing with. Wisdom for building a kingdom family. Not just any family. Because you see, any family can be represented anyhow. A kingdom family is different. Why I have put wisdom for building a kingdom family is that I think if you have been in church or you are born again or you have just been in the world, you've seen families and you've seen the standards people have in families and how people can break their promise, how people can break their standard, how people today can make vows to each other and tomorrow those vows don't count for nothing. That is in the world, and sorry to say this, even now in Christendom. In Christianity, you can marry and divorce anytime. It's different in the kingdom, and that's why I'm specifically saying wisdom for building kingdom families. I'm focusing on kingdom because the message in the kingdom of God is different than the message that people have just gone with. A lot of people are emotional about what I'm dealing with right now. And a lot of people have got their opinions. So we're going to stick to the word of God and not people's opinions. Because everyone has an opinion on this. And I want you to see how they came to Jesus in Matthew 19. In Matthew 19 from verse 3. Some Pharisees came to him to test him and they asked, is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any and every reason? Now, imagine this is 2,000 plus years ago. Because 2,000 years ago, that's when Jesus was here. Now we have gone 2,000 plus. A question was posed. People came to Jesus and they started telling Jesus to say, is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any and every reason? Imagine the same way we are facing divorce here, the same way divorce has become a rampage right now. That's the way it was in the time of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that's why I quoted Ecclesiastes to say, chapter 1, there is nothing new under the sun. Because imagine what we are facing today is nothing new. It's the same thing they were facing 2,000 years ago. Now, if what we are facing is nothing new, it means the answer to it is not going to be anything new. You know, Hosea says, Hosea 4:6, My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. When you read Isaiah chapter 5, verse 13, it says, my people have gone into captivity because of not having understanding. When you read Psalms 82, verse 5, Psalms 82, verse 5 says, they know nothing, they understand nothing, therefore they walk about in darkness. I want you to follow this. Hosea says, my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge. Isaiah says, they have gone into captivity, they have gone into bondage because of not having understanding. Psalm says, they know nothing, 82 verse 5. They know nothing, they understand nothing, therefore they walk about in darkness, and all the foundations of the earth are out of course. A lot of people are ignorant about the counsel and the mind of God concerning the family. They came to Jesus and they asked him, can a man divorce? Can a woman divorce for any and every reason? I want you to listen to his answer. Verse 4. I'm in Matthew 19. I was reading verse 3. Now this is verse 4. Jesus' response was, haven't you read? He replied, that at the beginning the Creator made them male and female. Now I want you to follow this. They came to him to talk to him about divorce, a relationship breaking up, a relationship failing. And he answers them to say, the issue is not the relationship that you're talking about that has failed. The issue is, what knowledge did the people have? The issue is not the divorce or the failure in relationship. The issue is, what knowledge was there in the two people that were in the relationship? So he says, haven't you read? Meaning, the problem is more to do with knowledge and understanding and ultimately wisdom than it is with people failing to handle a home and to live in a home. I'm pausing because this is critical. A lot of people, their marriages are failing, their relationships are failing, not because they are supposed to fail, not because the devil is too strong, not because in the underworld they've declared war against every Christian marriage, every marriage in the kingdom of God. Not because of that. That is there. We've been doing deliverance now for over 20 years as a ministry. And at intervals, through interaction as you are dealing with deliverance, you would hear that hell is against kingdom families. And he wants to break down homes because of the impact and the effect it has on the children and the two people in the divorce. That is there, we know that. To say they have got a target over the family. There is a target to break a family. There is a target to destroy. And don't forget, they work in a system. Let me give you a practical example. Have you seen that Hollywood shows that divorce, marrying and remarrying is okay? And that's what people watch every day. Everything called the series, movies that people are watching, divorce is being sold as the norm, as you have to live the way you want to live. And if something is not working, just jump out of it. Now imagine, that is the entertainment, that is the news, that is the knowledge, that's the social platform where people are at. Without knowing, people have already been prepared for divorce. I'm pausing. People have already been prepared. Or by the time you assimilate everything you have watched up to now, you're already ready for divorce. Why? You've seen the people whom you thought would never divorce have divorced. You've seen people who were your idols, people who were your icons, people you look to have divorced. So before realizing, you have already been pre-programmed for divorce. Now, worst of all, not just Hollywood that has been selling that, not just the world that has been selling that, now even people in church are now divorcing. So guess what? What was an anchor, what was supposed to be an example, what was supposed to be now a model, what was supposed to now hold, is now not holding. And that's why I'm saying this is going to be one of the most important series you've ever followed. Why? Hell has got a mandate. Hell has got an agenda. 2005, 2006, we did training in Rhema, South Africa. As we were doing the 3 years training, there was one course in particular, Christian counseling, that we did for 1 year in the third year. And we had one of the top doctors, highly educated man, a psychologist who taught us in that Christian counseling. And he said some things concerning divorce and the tearing that happens on divorce. Do you know that a lot of people do not understand when God says, "I hate divorce," what he implied? The tearing that happens when a divorce takes place, most of the time people don't recover from that. And if you are seated to a divorced person or you know a divorced person, in your own time, go and talk to them and ask them. People were not meant to separate after they become one. So when they become one, when God says what God has joined together, what God has made one, let no man separate. That separating of people who had become one, and I know I'm already going ahead of myself, that separating, most of the time, those two individuals involved do not get totally healed. Find out from the people they marry. It's just that they can't say the truth to the person that they have married after they have come out of the divorce. But they are fragments of the other person in their life. And they can't tell the new person to say, "This one was like this," or "I'm still dreaming about this one," or "I still smell this one," or "I'm still connected to this one," because that other person can't understand, they can't swallow. So these are now areas that a person can be married and it will never be brought up. It's only us people who are pastors who now have the privilege, as you are dealing with some situations in a home, that somebody begins to pour out their heart and open up to say, "This is what is happening." What am I saying? Divorce is not the answer. By the time you finish this series, first of all, you will not rush into marriage. I want you to see what Jesus did. They came to him to ask him about divorce. He went and challenged their knowledge. They said, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any and every reason?" He says, no, leave the marriage alone. Haven't you read?" Meaning, you're talking about marriage. I'm trying to deal with, what do you know? What do you understand? Do you understand how God began? What are the two ingredients God used to bring out the first marriage? Who were the people God brought together and joined together? So the first thing Jesus said, which was very important at the beginning, was knowledge. Haven't you read? Now, we have been married with my wife this month. December 15th will be clocking 20 years. Do you know we've been marriage counselors for 19 years? Because of the assignment on our lives, we started this thing early. Do you know that for counseling marriages in 19 years, the different marriages we've counseled, do you know that people who come to be counseled, most of the time come to be counseled because they have to, because it's a must, not that they want to get understanding? And you know, I'm pausing because there's too much weight on what I'm saying. Every church has got a prerequisite before they bless you in church. you have to go through marital counseling. They have to counsel you. That's when you qualify for the pastor or that ministry to bless you in their church. Now, it's a prerequisite, meaning if you don't go through counseling, they will not bless you. Do you know that people do the counseling to fulfill all righteousness, not to learn and get understanding? And a lot of people, do you know that a couple can spend 50,000 on a wedding? They can't buy one book for 200 quarta on marriage. I'm pausing because you see, these are things that people, we are good at blaming demons. We are good about talking about how things have fallen. Oh, how this altar has risen, how this is fighting me. We are good at all that. Listen to what I'm telling you. A person can pay 50,000 for a wedding. They can't buy two books for 500. A person, they will put on the best. They will dress. They will spend, even if it's 10,000 on themselves for the wedding day. They can spend that type of amount. They can book the best car, best hotel. They will do everything. Ask them how many books they've bought. They can't buy a book. Do you know that if you sit with couples and you ask them to say, before you are talking about getting married, tell me, let's use the number of completion. Tell me seven books that you've read on marriage. Okay, maybe seven is too much. Let's use grace. Five stands for grace. Show me five books that you have read so that you just have enough grace to make it in the marriage. They can't show you five books. They can't show you seven books. You know why? Knowledge is not a prerequisite for most people. Understanding is not the focus of most people. Do you know wisdom has never been a priority in people's lives? Now, when you read the Bible, wisdom is the first before anything. Let me read Proverbs. Don't forget Matthew 19, that's our main text. That's where we sit through the whole series. But I want to show you something in Proverbs 8. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 11. Let me start maybe even from verse 10. Proverbs chapter 8, verse 10 says, "Choose my instruction instead of silver." Proverbs chapter 8, verse 10. "Choose my instruction instead of silver, knowledge rather than choice gold." Verse 11, "For wisdom is more precious than rubies, and nothing you desire can compare with her." Now, the Bible says choose knowledge. Choose instructions. What is marital counseling? Instruction. What I normally tell couples when we're counseling them and preparing them for marriage to say, the counseling you get is the marriage. The marriage is not what happens when they bless you on the altar. No. The marriage is your counseling, meaning the people who counsel you, the wisdom they have, the understanding they have, that is your actual marriage. If wrong people counsel you, if people who don't have understanding counsel you, and we've heard things that I can't even speak of on TV, or a person who's counseling young ones and they tell them demands of things that are contrary and are wrong, are not in the scriptures. Please hear what you're hearing. The person who counsels you, that's your marriage. If they don't have light, you enter with the darkness that they have. If they have little light, you enter with the little light that they have. Anything that they have been exposed to, that is what you're going to be exposed to. Please listen to what the Bible says. "For wisdom is more precious than rubies, and nothing you desire." I know you desire to get married. I know you desire to have a relationship. I know you desire for this thing to work. But the Bible says there's nothing you desire that can compare to wisdom. So wisdom is now what becomes the anchor. What have I spoken about today? And please, I want you to follow this because I'm laying a foundation. And God has been schooling me in this for over 22 years. So the foundation I'm going to lay is going to be broad and deep. There's nothing new under the sun. People are divorcing today. People were divorcing in the time of Jesus. But when the master was asked, he started bringing wisdom. He started bringing knowledge that no one should ever reach and be in a painful, broken relationship. Jesus began unlocking what a kingdom home is like, the wisdom that brings success in a kingdom home. And in Proverbs, we are reading to say, you desire to get married, wisdom is better than marriage, because wisdom can keep the marriage. You desire to have a woman, you desire to have a man as a life partner, and you enter into this covenant, your wisdom about who you are, your wisdom about the opposite sex, your wisdom about who a man is, your wisdom about who a woman is, your wisdom about marriage, what it entails, the covenant that you enter into, is more important than the marriage itself that you want to get into. If you have been watching this and you are saying, Pastor Manasseh, I want to understand more, I want you to catch me on the next episode as I continue laying the foundation on how to build a successful kingdom family. This has been Pastor Wesley Manasseh. God bless you. Success is determined by the wisdom that you have. If you don't have wisdom, you cannot produce success. There is a wisdom that controls a home. There is a wisdom that governs a relationship. There is a wisdom that governs communication.
You see, it's not my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge, because they didn't get knowledge. No! You rejected knowledge.